fall is here. The fall, our fall, America's fall. As you look closer at America, we're rotten. We've forgotten our morals. We've let go of our faith. We're barely hanging on. Christians are stressed out like never before, not trusting in God, forgetting who they are, not doing what they're here to do. Jesus told us, go out and spread the gospel, heal the sick, save the lost, feed the widows, take care of the orphans. But how many of us are doing that? Because I don't know about you, but I have very few people that I know that are actually doing the will of God anymore. Most are sitting around complaining about their finances, complaining about their lives, complaining about how sick they are. And I'm not excluding myself in that group. I'm saying we Christians have lost it. We've forgotten who we are. We are commanded to go spread the gospel. We are commanded to preach repentance to the lost. We are commanded to heal the sick. And yet I don't see that we're doing that. I see that we are all sitting behind our computers, sitting in our homes, praying. But Jesus never said, hide in your holes and just pray for each other. He said, go out amongst the lost. Go out into the world. Go out into the darkness where there is no light. Go out and spread my word. Go out and spread the good news. How come we're not doing that? How come we're lost in ourselves? How come we're so afraid of doing what God has commanded us to do? He sent Jesus as an example, and yet I don't see too many examples of Jesus out there in the world. I see Christians, weak, scared, angry. They've forgotten who they are. Why? Why aren't we out there doing what Jesus commanded us? I'll tell you why. Because we've taken our eyes off of God and put them onto ourselves, put them onto our lives. We want comfort. We want security. We want things to be okay, and then we'll go do it. But that's not what Jesus said. If you're a pastor, what are you doing sitting in your home, not preaching to the lost, not evangelizing, not doing everything within your power, within your might, within your ability, with the resources God has given you to go out and preach the gospel? I don't care if you've got to stand on a street corner or reach people at a bar. Do something. The time is near. The darkness is falling. Each one of us is called to be Jesus' disciples, and yet I don't see that. I see crippled, maimed Christians crying out for a dollar to pay their bills, crying out for another prayer, when we're the ones who are supposed to be out there praying for the lost, praying for the sick, praying for others. But every Christian I know is broken. What happened to us? Forget about saving the enemy. We can't even save ourselves. I'm embarrassed sometimes to even say that I'm a Christian because I look at the mess that Christians are in. How are we to be the light of the world, the salt of the earth, when we can't even walk in Jesus' ways ourselves? I challenge each one of us to begin, to truly begin, to take a new step forward, to really try to do what Jesus has called you to do. To forget about your comforts, to forget about your circumstances, to stop looking at yourself and your life. To just look at God, just step out. Forget about looking like a fool. Forget about whether they like you or not. It's not a popularity contest. You may never be liked. People may hate you. People may even try to kill you. So what? Don't you understand? That comes with the territory when you said, yes, I place Jesus as my Lord and Savior. What do you think they did to him? And why don't you think they might do it to you too? I know that the closer I grow to God and walk with him, the more enemies I get, the more I'm hated, the more friends and family turn from me. And do you think that it's easy It is if I can keep my eyes on God. It is if I can keep my eyes on the truth. It is if I know the end of the story. It is if I know that my reward is coming. You see, when you're standing on that rock, when you're standing on that truth, it's irrelevant. Everything else becomes irrelevant. Whether you're loved, whether you're broke, is irrelevant. Whether you're in a good place or a bad place is irrelevant. Serve God where you're at. Do what He's asked you to do. Whatever it is, do it. However large or small, do it. Step out of your boat. It's time. Our nation is going to fall. And if you're not out there serving the Lord, if you're not walking close to God and keeping your eyes totally on Him, not looking at each other, not waiting for an email from a friend to give you hope or encouragement, but you walking side by side with God, with Jesus, with the Holy Spirit, doing what He's commanded you to do, you won't see nothing else. You won't have time for nothing else. You'll have time to do what God said, and that'll keep you busy. And that'll give you every challenge you ever need. I'm telling you, people, we Christians need to start looking, acting, talking like Christians. We Christians need to get our acts together. We Christians need to start shining with the light of Jesus in us. We Christians need to become the message. We need to become the scriptures. Jesus said He was the scriptures. He didn't need to go around preaching the scriptures night and day. He was the scriptures. He was the message. We need to do what He did. We need to become the message. And everywhere we go, we're going to give that message, whether it's with our actions, with a smile, with a hug, with our words. We need to walk as Christians. We need to start praying for the lost, start praying for the sick. We are going to be held responsible for being royalty, for being ambassadors of Christ, and doing nothing with that title. Just sitting on the throne, wanting all the glory, wanting everyone to love us, wanting everyone to come to our churches, hear our sermons. But we're not willing to get out of the boat, to get our knees dirty, to be shot at, to be hated, to go through whatever we got to go through. How dare we call ourselves Christians then? When you're a true Christian, you're willing to pay any price, and I mean anything, and stop complaining. Complaining shows you're looking at yourself. Complaining shows that God has not provided enough for you. Complaining shows an ungrateful heart. And don't even write to me with your complaints, saying how it's okay for you to complain because it's in the Bible. I'm telling you, God doesn't like it because it shows an ungrateful heart. What He loves is our praise. What He loves is us singing and dancing. What He loves is us really acting like children who trust Him, who love Him, who just can't wait to go out there and tell the good news to everyone. The ones who recently came to the Lord that I know of, they're the ones I see on fire out there. They're the ones I see so excited to go serve the Lord with all their hearts. They're the ones I'm seeing making major differences in their lives. And I'm saying, how come it's those that are just saved? How come it's those that are returning to the Lord after being apart from Him for so long? They're so on fire. How come we aren't? We, all of us, need to get our acts together.